The Dutch government must be clear that there can be no resumption of business as usual with Beijing, while the persecution of Uyghur Muslims, Christians, and other religious and ethnic minorities in China continue. China has repeatedly refused to answer mounting allegations of grave human rights abuses in Xinjiang region, including mass imprisonment and forced labor. Earlier this year, the Interparliamentary Alliance on China released evidence that the Chinese government is pursuing a birth prevention program targeting at Muslim minorities in the region. And if that is true, a deliberate policy to reduce the population of minority groups could meet internationally agreed upon criteria of genocide. China must allow unimpeded access to the region of Xinjiang for a UN-led investigation into these allegations. The imposition of the national security law criminalizes legitimate political activities and several curtails individual freedoms. It violates Hong Kong's autonomy guaranteed by the Sino-British Joint Declaration, a binding treaty under international law, the Hong Kong Basic Law, and the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights.
Actually, Dutch Uyghur Human Rights Foundation, before this, we drafted a Dutch Uyghur Human Rights Policy Act to the Dutch Parliament to punish the Chinese government officials who has ties with the Uyghur genocides. But the Dutch government responded that they are just going to discuss it in within the framework of European Union. And the US government is doing their best, I think. But in my opinion, the Wang Yi, the foreign ministry of a Chinese government, should be arrested, actually. He should be held in front of the International Criminal Court. But the other government is still calling them a minister or president. And it's a regime of a dictatorship and a genocide. But because of their economic leverage, economic power, they just buy out the silence of the majority of the third world country, and also a lot of European countries.